Hey, let's get ready and roll. It's your time to make 700 grand. Everybody. But the deal is that if you just want to make, there has to be a science. I'm laying it out today. Now, if you'll listen, by the way, it will be a checkup from the neck up. I will tell you some things that you'll enjoy hearing, and I will tell you some things that you're going to hate to hear. But at least I'll tell you the truth, and then you decide what you want to do with it. But don't ever tell yourself that you couldn't get there, because today I'm giving you the secret sauce. And look, by the way, I wrote some stuff up here. Let's write down 6 key things right out the gate. Number one, and write it down, 700 grand. Next to it, write this, sounds overwhelming. The reason why is because when you look at the number and you look at your 200 grand year to date right now, and we're in November or less, maybe a little more, you're like, sounds overwhelming. It's not. Not if you know what to do. If I wanted to make, if a guy came up to me and I was making 700 grand, he said, Andy, you could make 2 million. I'd be like, you don't understand how hard I work to get to 700. I don't think that's humanly possible. Let's go. Number two, write it down. Do the research. David Goggins broke the pull-up record, 4,020 pull-ups. And when he did, how he did it was he got a pen and paper and he did the math. That was all he did. Everybody said, hey, you want to break the pull-up record? He's like, how many is it? They're like, it's 4,020. He's like, oh man, where's the pen and paper? How many pull-ups is that a minute? How much time do I have to rest? He started doing the math. This is where you guys are going to start chiming in light bulbs in your head thinking, man, I've been doing it all wrong. So 4,020. He said, if I could do 5 pull-ups a minute, Goggins said I could break the record. 5 pull-ups a minute is realistic. You would just have to be consistent with those 5. Now here's what I want to tell you guys. We're creeping up on the last 90 days of this year. Next year, 365 days, and every year we get till we die. You guys do the math. Slow down. Don't worry about what anybody else is doing. Think about what you're going to do starting now. Right here. Number one, 700 grand sounds overwhelming. I gave you David Goggins. Number two. Number three, be open-minded. If you're not open-minded to the possibilities that you can do this, you can't do it. You've just counted yourself out. You're done. Just log off, go back to work, or you are like everyone else. You have to be open-minded to the possibility that you can do this. Number four, once you shut your mind down, write this down. Number four, once I shut my mind down, Chuck, okay, write it down. Once you shut your mind down to the possibility that this can be achieved, there's no way it can happen. Your mind is what I need right now. I need your mind. I need it. I need everybody to give it to me. I'm going to ask you guys for something right here. I like to be kind of blunt and straightforward. I'm going to need you guys to let me brainwash you for a minute. That's what I'm going to need. I'm going to brainwash you in a good way that everyone else told you in your life, and I need to take it out of your damn head. I need you to empty your head out. Empty it. Cobwebs, weeds, negativity, low self-limiting beliefs, glass ceiling, self-doubt. I need it all gone. Let's talk about some other stuff. Pride. Some of you guys have had the best year ever. You think you're too good. Good enough. Get that out of your head. You're just getting started. When we first started training together, you went from here to here because you started believing in yourself. You got a little skill, but now you're stuck here. Now I'm trying to take you way up there. For some reason, you stopped somewhere. And successful people are crazy. They're unreasonable. Average people will reason with their dreams every day. I got a dream. I tell someone else. He's like, dude, listen, man, I think it's a little too big. Why don't you lower it down just a tad? Make it realistic. The guy does it. When you meet somebody who's successful or is going to be, when you tell them what's going to happen, they're unreasonable. They're like, dude, I don't care what you think. I don't care the math you did. I don't care who you know. I don't care how long you've been doing it. Don't care. Number five, you have to do the math and keep attacking. Some of you guys have stopped attacking. Some of you guys don't attack daily. You attack once a week, twice a week. You don't attack every day. And that's bullcrap. Number six, this is my favorite. Break the soul of whatever's in. Okay?
Let's go,
listen,
baby.
Listen.
Hey, yeah, little Monday running. Hey, Andy Elliott. Get those squats after this. Taking listen, souls, baby.
David Goggins taking souls. He started talking about you have to break the soul of whatever's in front of you. You have to break the soul, whether it's a person, an object, or when I talk about a soul here. I am talking about taking up space in your competition's head. Very clearly. If I'm going to go fight somebody and we're 6 weeks out to fight day, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to run by his office every day and swing it in the air and just making sure that that guy's thinking about Big Daddy. I'm going to get in his soul. You know why? Because if I do, he can't focus, and I'm laser focused. There is a strategy. Underdogs take down Goliaths every day. The story of David and Goliath, all these big warriors, Goliath stands up. He's like, come on, come out here. Fight me, we'll win the war. You just send one man out here. He beats me. Guess what? We save everybody's lives. But guess what? If I kill you, you guys are my slaves forever. All the big warriors, the ones who've trained forever, you know what? They were like, no way, shaking in their boots. Little baby David says, man, give me this guy. Come on, man, this is a joke. Some of you guys, this is a joke that we're not where we need to be yet. And you know why? Because you don't want it bad enough yet, okay? And you don't believe. One thing about David is when David walked up to Goliath, he believed. There was no self-doubt. He knew God has his favor. He went out there and chopped his damn head off in about 30 seconds. Your giant in life could be the problems you got going on in your life, the way you were raised. Problems are good. You got problems, good. It gives you an opportunity to solve them. And you're alive to handle them. The person that has the highest threshold of pain can be the most successful and make most money. People keep quitting. You guys who can handle the pain, the hater, the grind, the trials, stinging you, people deceiving you, you're capable for greatness. You know why? Because you're not soft. You still keep moving. You don't quit.